Friends, welcome back to my channel. When we are testing any signal using oscilloscope and it is vibrating, it is jumping, it is dancing, it is moving left to right, right to left, whatsoever, how we can stabilize it on the display? This is a question from my viewer. He is saying that, very nice, I see the curve in the DSO are stable. In mine, they travel all along the screen. Any idea? It is due to trigger, because oscilloscope uses trigger function to display any signal, to plot any signal on the screen. First, let me stop it. This signal, it contains many samples. We can provide any reference point. From that point, it will start to display. If you will say here, this point, at that time, it will start to sample signal from here, and then it will trigger at the same voltage level. So we can select any one portion of the pulse from top side or the bottom side. Vertical setting, horizontal setting, and this is trigger portion. Now if we see trigger menu, from here menu, here we have triggering, edge triggering, pulse triggering, slope triggering, video, edge trigger, that is good. Then source, this oscilloscope will start to record signal when we have any valid signal on that source. We have one source, two, three. Fourth source is line voltage, 50 hertz or 60 hertz trigger signal. If you are using channel 1, when signal will reach at channel 1, and that signal will obtain that required threshold, which we will set here, that this signal, when it will reach at 0.1 volt, for example, or 1 millivolt, it will start to record. It will start to plot the signal. It will start to record the signal. It will start sampling. We can say it is a trigger to initiate recording. If you will select channel 2, this time channel 2 port is open. If you will select channel 2, this oscilloscope will not get ready to record signal. It will display signal random, but it don't have any reference. If we select external, we need to start external signal. For example, we apply pulse, that when this pulse will arrive up to 5 millivolt, 1 millivolt, whatsoever, which level we will adjust here, external level, then it will start recording from channel 1. But now in our condition, we are using just only one signal. Then if we are using AC line, if we are measuring line voltage or any low frequency signal, we can select line trigger. But in our case, we are just only measuring this signal, and it is complex signal. This signal contains multiple voltage levels. So we need to define a specific portion of the wave shape. From that, it will start to trigger, it will start to record. Trigger source channel 1, then we need to select trigger level. For example, this area, now it is stabilized. If I will select here, we can see it is now vibrating, dancing. Here is trigger level 1.6 volt. When voltage level at channel number 1 will increase 1.6 volt, at that time it will start to trigger. If I set to minus 4 volt, it cannot trigger. Why? Because it cannot find minus 4 volt, because our signal is reaching from 0 volt to upside. When it is reaching 400 millivolt, it starts to display a valid signal. But if the trigger level is in minus, it will not display signal. The very important thing, that is, from which source we are triggering. If we are using signal at channel number 1, from same signal we want to trigger it. This signal is coming at channel 1, it will start to record that pulse from here. So we say channel number 1. If I will select channel 2, at that time its display will not stable until we provide signal at channel 2. Then if we say external, at that time we need to provide external signal here. So oscilloscope will synchronize our measurement, or it will start measurement when pulse will reach at this pin, when we are using external trigger or we are using AC line. If we are applying signal to channel 1, at that condition we can set to AC line or we can select to channel 1. This time I am setting it to channel 1. Run. Still it is not stabilized, because now we need to adjust the level. We can see this trigger level is now at very bottom level, so it cannot sense any trigger voltage. Now we can see I adjusted it at this slope. If I will set it here, here are many pulses. We can see this orange line, this time it at first pulse here it will trigger, but then there are many pulses, so this oscilloscope cannot take any valid reference for recording the pulse. So we need to adjust at least any one stable point of the pulse. Here it is stabilized. So this is the method that we can use trigger level function. In some oscilloscopes there are positive edge triggering, negative edge triggering. So we can use the trigger level, either we are using cathode ray oscilloscope, the analog oscilloscope or digital oscilloscopes. We need to align the trigger level. If this video is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.